Hi everyone, happy Sunday to you all. It's Naomi Kanaika from Encouragement from the Word of God. This is my daughter, Hosanna. Say hi.
Hi.
All right, so today it's a beautiful Sunday and we're so excited because today is a full day of so many exciting things. Today our church is having an art exhibition and so many art and skills products that we are going to have a fundraiser for our church building, and we're going early to help with the setup and get all everything ready, and we are so excited. Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm going to go.
Yes. So today we're going to, before we go, and we have church today as well, and the service is at 10:30, this church service, and after 10:30 service, we're going to, 12 o'clock is the art show and the exhibition and so many other things. All right, Hosanna, go and sit there. All right, today I'm going to talk with you about a beautiful scripture verse that I found in, as we were reading our devotional, 2 Samuel chapter 24. And it talks about David. And we can see that David had sinned, and God was not pleased with David because he had a great army, and David was not depending on God. So God says that there are three ways that I can punish you. So he gives an option that you can choose which one you want. And we can see that David is saying, God, I have sinned. I'm really sorry. And he says, I prefer to be punished by you than to be punished by the people. And then we can see that God, David is want to do a sacrifice to their God. And David wants to come and build an altar and worship God and sacrifice and offer him a praise offering. So we see him that he goes to Arunah, a man named Arunah, and then he comes and he asks his man, and he says that I want to buy your threshing floor because I want to build an altar to the Lord that the plague of the people may be stopped. So Arunah said, Oh Lord, my king, you can take whatever you wish, and you can even have an oxen for offering, and here is the threshing sledge and oxen for the wood. Your majesty, you can take everything. And then when Arunah says that, King David says, no, I insist on paying you for it. I will not sacrifice to the Lord, my God, burnt offerings that cost me nothing. This is a beautiful verse that David wants to offer God a sacrifice, and he wants to offer not a free thing that he has received, but he wants it to cost him. He wants it to cost him, so that he's offering a sacrificial offering from his heart, so that it'll be a fragrant offering to God. As we know that Jesus Christ was a sacrificial lamb when he suffered and he died for us. He was a sacrificial lamb. He was the only Son of God, and he was the Father's Son, beloved Son, and God sacrificed everything for us. And David wanted to sacrifice, and he said, I love this verse where he says, I do not want to sacrifice to the Lord my God burnt offerings that cost me nothing. I don't know about you, but it really wants me to think about our offerings to our God. Whatever we give, maybe our time, our abilities, whatever, most of the time, even I myself, gives the leftovers to God, gives whatever is left over. But I want to give him the best. I want it to cost me something. I want it to cost my time. I want it to really feel as a sacrifice I'm doing, a sacrificial offering to him. We see the same story when Jesus goes to the temple and sees the rich people offerings. And he's this woman, the widow woman, who has only two coins and offers both the two coins. And that was her livelihood, and she sacrificed it all. It was a sacrificial offering. And we see in Mark chapter 12 that Jesus looks at the woman, and Jesus says that this woman, poor widow, has put more to the treasury than all the others. How can it be? This woman put only two coins, and that was the smallest coins ever. it might be the 25 cents. But she, her offering was more bigger and more valuable than everyone else's. How can it be? God really looks at your heart. There are several things that God looks where man overlooks. And God looks at your heart. God sees if your sacrifice is truly a sacrifice to God. And then God looks at it in a, evaluate in a different way than a man evaluates. Man looks at the amount, but God looks at really what is the purpose. What did she do? And also it was an act of faith this woman had. She gave everything she had, her livelihood, everything. To give everything, she had to have faith. So I want to encourage you today, whatever that might be, God wants us to have a sacrifice when we're offering something to our Lord. God has given us many things, everything that our life belongs to Him, our breath belongs to Him, our possessions belong to Him, our land belongs to Him, our house belongs to Him, our children belong to Him, our breath of life belongs to Him, our bodies belong to Him. Everything belongs to Him. Let us sacrifice. Let us sacrifice. As David said, I love when he says that, that I will not sacrifice something that does not cost me. I want it to cost me. I want my time that I spend with God to cost me. I want the things that I do for others to cost me so that I can glorify God. It should cost us. So I hope that this encouraged you today. Let's pray together. Father, Lord, we thank you for this beautiful day. Lord, we come to you. Lord, we are so excited for everything that's planned today. The art exhibition and the products that they will be selling and the ministries that they'll be introducing. Bless it today, Lord, the TLC Arts Ministry today. I pray for everyone who's going to help, Lord, everything to come back properly and everything to go well, and that we would raise great amount of funds for your kingdom, for our church building. Lord, we give you glory. Lord, let us sacrifice things that are given to us so freely. Let us sacrifice. Let it be a sacrifice. Let it cost us to offer you our life. Lord, we give you glory, honor, and praise. In the mighty name of Jesus we pray. Amen. I hope you were blessed today.
Hosanna, I don't want you to go out. Can you come here?
I just want to sing one worship song. It's called Don Mion. It's from Don Mion. It's called I Offer My Life. It's a beautiful worship song. Let me try to put the music because it's so beautiful when the music is on.
Ontario homeowners. Before you start planning your move to a new home, you'll want to know exactly what your
Lord, I offer my life to you, everything I've been through. Use it for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life.
Sing it.
Lord, I offer my life to you, everything I've been through. Use it for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life. things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet to come true. All of my hopes and all of my plans, my heart and my hands, I lift them to you. Lord, I offer my life to you, everything I've been through. Use it for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my prayers to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you my life.
I hope you were blessed today. So happy Sunday. May you enjoy worshiping the Lord with your church family. And also, may you glorify God. And may something that you give to the Lord, may it be sacrificial and may it cost you. Just like David said, I want to give something that cost me to my God, my Savior, because everything I have belongs to Him. Have a wonderful day. God bless you. Bye. If you are around this area in Toronto, please drop by to see our art show. It's at the Lakeside Church. If you type on Google the Lakeside Church Toronto, you can find the address that our church is, and we have the exhibition starting from 12 o'clock. If you are interested, please even send me a message and I can give you the directions as well. It's at 12 o'clock and it's going to be an exciting event. Have a wonderful day. God bless you. Bye.